Patrick. I have some important news to tell you.
What is it, buddy?
I'm pregnant.
What? How did that happen?
I don't know, but I'm sure excited about it.
This is huge. We're going to be parents.
Yeah, we are.
I think we just peaked with AI technology. So if you've been living under a rock, you may or may not have heard of this AI SpongeBob livestream that's playing in the background right now. And it's basically 30-second segments of SpongeBob and the gang talking amongst each other on one designated topic that's decided by Discord users.
What could possibly go wrong?
So in Discord, someone will suggest a topic like, SpongeBob, what are your thoughts about LSD? And then bam, they just have a full-on conversation on live stream for everyone to enjoy. Now, as horrible as all of these topics and these generations are, the idea or the concept is actually pretty cool, and that's what I kind of want to go over today, how they created this AI live stream and how you guys can do it as well. But first, let's talk about some of these possibilities with AI now that we just never thought was going to be a thing in the future. At least I never thought this would be possible, but now it is. Just last week, NVIDIA released video game footage of someone having a full-on conversation with an NPC in a video game, but it was an AI-driven NPC that could respond to real-time questions.
How come?
I'm worried about the crime around here. It's gotten bad lately. My ramen shop got caught in the crossfire.
Can I help?
If you want to do something about this, I have heard rumors that the powerful crime lord Kumon Aoki is causing all sorts of chaos in the city. He may be the root of this violence.
I'll talk to him. Where can I find him?
I have heard he hangs out in the underground fight clubs on the city's east side.
Now, ever since ChatGPT came out, I knew this was coming, but how fast it is within NVIDIA is absolutely crazy, and it feels like you're genuinely having a conversation with one of the video game characters. Now, just like that video game's SpongeBob AI is the same thing where you get real-time answers based off of ChatGPT, although it's not exactly as real-time as you think, and I'll get into that later in this video. With that being said, let's head over to the computer and I'll show you how they made this possible.
Alrighty, so this process is basically broken up into five main steps. There's a lot more smaller details that goes into it, but the fine overarching steps of how this AI live stream was made starts with ChatGPT or GPT-3. As the creator stated, they used GPT-3, the DaVinci model. So I'll just show you in GPT-3.5, kind of a rough idea of how this prompt worked. I don't know if this is the exact prompt that they use for their videos. It's most likely not. They probably use something a lot more descriptive, but I believe it's something along the lines of using the topic, and then it inserts the topic that's recommended by the Discord users. Create a conversation between two characters that lasts 5 exchanges. So when we hit enter, we're going to see what we're going to get. And as you guys can see, we have character A, character B. So character A would be SpongeBob, character B would be Patrick. And we have our conversation using the topic SpongeBob steals a car. Hey, have you heard the latest gossip about SpongeBob? No, what's going on with SpongeBob now? You won't believe it. SpongeBob actually stole a car. So it sounds pretty similar to the conversations that are happening on that live stream. Just absolutely ridiculous. Now, the thing is, there isn't someone on the back end of this live stream just like constantly typing up in ChatGPT to get new topics and new exchanges. This is all done through AI. It's all automated through Python, which I'll get into in a bit later down the line in this video. So really, this is the easiest part of the process, is just generating that exchange. All you need is a placeholder for the topic, which I have in quotes here, and it's really that simple. Now, I'm sure they have GPT-3 installed on their computer, so they don't even have to use it on ChatGPT online. Now, the next thing they use is a program called UberDuck. It is a text-to-speech program. So basically, that's how they make SpongeBob sound like SpongeBob and Patrick sound like Patrick. Although I wouldn't say it's perfect. They definitely do sound like the characters, but the AI is pretty wonky, and it honestly makes the live streams that much better. I feel like if the voices were perfect, it would honestly be less funny. But yeah, UberDuck is very similar to a program like 11 Labs. If you have experience with that, it works the exact same. Now, if you want to try out UberDuck, they have a free plan. plan where you don't have to pay anything. And you can actually do more. You can literally make like rap songs. We're not going to do that. What we want is custom voices. Now you can actually train your own custom voice if you choose to do so, but they already actually have SpongeBob voices on the website. So you wouldn't even have to train your own model, which is fantastic. Alrighty, so I'm just going to go over to ChatGPT and copy one of the exchanges. And then I'm going to go back over to UberDuck and I'm going to paste in that text. I'm going to make sure we're on SpongeBob SquarePants, SpongeBob SquarePants. And we are going to synthesize and let's see what we get.
I know, right? I couldn't believe it either, but the rumors are spreading like wildfire. Apparently, he took it for a joyride in Bikini Bottom.
So as you guys can hear, that sounds nearly identical to the voices that are played on the live stream. So obviously you can go to actions and download your video. However, I'm almost positive they're not actually using the website and they have it somehow installed locally on their computer the same way as GPT DaVinci. Now with our AI generated voice and our AI generated script, that is the easy stuff. And that is kind of where my knowledge starts to veer off. As the next thing they use is Unity Game Engine. Now it's to my knowledge that they use the Unity Game Engine to basically connect the AI voice and the AI generated text into a game that is basically played live. Now whenever you get those We'll Be Right Back screens, that's actually the automation process loading in the new voices and the new text, which does take a couple seconds, although it's still pretty fast. Now once it's played within Unity, the last thing to do is to actually stream it and get the video up on YouTube, and it would look something like this. I assume they use OBS or maybe Streamlabs OBS to put everything on live stream. Now I guarantee you've heard of this program before and I'm not going to go in depth on how to set things up within it. However, the difficult part is going to be automating this entire process, because obviously the creators of this AI live stream are not individually going in and changing out the text exchange between SpongeBob and converting the text to AI audio every single segment. This is all automated and it's done through a Python backend coming directly from the creator of this live stream. They use a program like so that I have on screen, and I can guarantee they use ChatGPT to help them come up with this program. So I imagine they asked ChatGPT something like this, or maybe they had a ton of coding experience and didn't need ChatGPT's help whatsoever. But if I was going to make a live stream similar to this, this is how I would start or where I would start. And ChatGPT is just going to give us the base code, but there's a lot of limitations. As you guys can see, OpenAI can't generate code for interacting directly inside Discord. So I'm very curious on how they get all the different topic ideas from Discord and then they bring it over into the program. But that's going to conclude this video on AI SpongeBob live streams and how they set it up, how they made it possible. If you want me to do a more in-depth tutorial, obviously, I just wanted to show you the bases and the different tools they use to make it possible, as the creator did come out and release how they made it, but he didn't go in depth. And I'm actually very curious myself on how I can make something similar to this. Maybe not as good of quality. I don't have any experience in Unity, but maybe like a 2D live stream. I feel like I could do that. So subscribe. Maybe that's coming soon. Have a good one. See ya later.